Hi, David Dilling from Markzware. Thank you for purchasing Q2ID version 5 from Markzware. On behalf of the Markzware team, we'd like to thank you. Today, this video is going to show you how to install and activate the license code for your Q2ID version 5. So, let's check it out. Today, we're going to show you how you install Q2ID version 5 in InDesign CS5. The same or extremely similar applies in CS4. You can download the installer on our webpage under Support and Product Updaters and Installer Files. You also will receive an email if you've purchased online, and generally the same if you purchase through a dealer or via the channel, with your license code and the download link. Make sure you choose the correct version, the latest Mac or Windows version 5, if you've purchased Q2ID version 5, the latest shipping version. Since I will show you on a Macintosh, which is also very similar on the Windows, I will click here. The actual installation is quite simple. You choose setup CS4 or CS5 depending on which version of InDesign you have. We naturally do recommend you first read the installation file so you see exactly what's expected from you. It is wise to have your license code handy, which will be in the same email where your download link was, generally speaking. Copy and paste the entire code for simplicity. Great, we'll choose CS5 in this case and start the installation process. The remove button is only there if you're upgrading from an older version. You'll want to get rid of your older version first to make sure there's no conflicts. In this case, we'll simply choose install. You'll see that happened very quickly. The installation takes seconds, literally. Now, the next step, which we recommend you do right now, is activate your license. For this, you'll need an active internet connection with no firewall in between. For advanced proxy settings and the likes, please go into your license control section of this installation setup file. For now, we'll choose activate. I've already copied and code from the email and it's ready to activate. What you'll now see, particularly on Macintosh, that an application was downloaded, the so-called license control I just mentioned. You'll want to open that. All right, great. So here we are in the Q2ID license control application. And this is where we can activate the license, better said. There's other options as well. Here's how we'll activate by copying, which we've done, and pasting our code in here. We can also find this application's license and activate it. That's for in situations where you're doing an update or upgrade. Sometimes, or if something strange happens on your system, you might need to refine the license and activate it. It's relatively automatic. Another great feature is the deactivation, which is simple to do with the internet connection. For instance, if I am working here on my workstation at work, but this weekend I need to work at home with Q2ID to convert Quark files to InDesign, I can deactivate with a click here, and then I can use this code on any other computer I'd like, and simply deactivate there and reactivate here if I need it back on this main machine. You can do this, deactivate, activate, as many times as you like. I can also show the status of this application's ID, and naturally, if my colleagues need Q2ID as well, I can purchase more licenses right from this window. Great, we're going to activate our new license here like we've just installed. Now we need to activate the license code. We simply paste it into here, and we hit next. You'll see now another window. We activate this license and hit next again. We read, understand, and agree to the license agreement, or not if that's the case. In this case, I of course do agree. And now you'll see we're back to this window. This is the one tricky part of our installation process to pay attention to. Before it said unlicensed here, now it says licensed for this system. my initial reaction was to hit next, but actually, because that's the right-hand side, generally that's where you click. However, it's actually now on the left-hand side. You want to click on finish to complete the process. And that's that. Now let's go into InDesign CS5 and see how Q2ID works. Once inside Adobe InDesign CS4 or CS5, you'll find Q2ID up top in the menu item, right-hand side, under the Markzware menu item, and Q2ID, you'll notice, Convert QuarkXPress Document. Couple notes. To check for the latest update, click here. And the license control, where you get further help for the licensing or deactivation of Q2ID. To convert a file, you simply select Convert QuarkXPress Document. Simply choose the QuarkXPress document you'd like to convert, just like you would any other InDesign document. Please note, Q2ID will convert any version of QuarkXPress, 8, 7, 6, 5, and even 4. Select and choose Open, and the conversion process begins. And there you have it, a completely converted QuarkXPress document now right within Adobe InDesign, ready for you to manipulate, change, and do whatever you need to do, just like you would with an InDesign normally. The conversion is incredibly complete. In another video, we will show you more information on how Q2ID operates. But this is it. You've now installed, successfully licensed, and used Q2ID version 5 from Markzware, the only tool that effectively allows you to open QuarkXPress documents right within Adobe InDesign. This is David Dilling, and on behalf of Markzware, we thank you for purchasing Q2ID. If you have any questions, please go to our webpage, www.markzware.com, or send us an email, give us a call, or tweet us on Twitter. Check us out on LinkedIn. Go to our Fanbook page on Facebook while you're getting the picture. Thank you. David Dilling, signing off.